to be telling the truth.
I know what's true and what's not.
We also took Teresa's story to this man, therapist Ray Wyre. He reads a transcript of our interview and listens to her voice.
It's no dream.
Few people, if any, in Britain have counselled as many victims of satanic abuse or Satanists themselves as Ray Wyre has. If there is an expert on satanic cults, it would have to be him.
Do you believe Teresa's story?
I believe Teresa's story. It's exactly the same story as I've heard from men who says they've done it.
You've dealt with other cases like hers?
Yes.
21 cases like hers, he says, in the past 2 years alone.
Themes like they were put in boxes with spiders and worms, where they were trapped in fear, where there was a high use of excrement and urine, where there was talk of human sacrifice.
Take just one of those rituals, putting children in boxes with spiders and worms. Now, listen to what Teresa told her mother.
And they had a coffin-like box that children were put in with spiders and snakes and the lid shut and left in there. I would have come out deranged. I could not have coped with that mentally at all.
You have evidence to back up stories like Teresa's, that this is really happening?
Well, we have that age of child, 6, 5 and 4, giving information that ties up with Teresa. How do those children know? How do those children able to describe rituals, to talk about ceremonies, to talk about sacrificing animals? How do those children know?
Nightmares, imagining it?
You can't imagine those things at 3 and 4 years old, and you also don't have the evidence of anal sex abuse and oral sex abuse and all that other abuse that clearly those children have experienced and endured.
Teresa's story, her account, doesn't really surprise you?
It doesn't surprise me in the light of satanic abuse, no.
Do you get frustrated with people who just won't accept that these things do happen?
Yes, because I've worked with murderers in prisons for years. Not that long ago, a boy was found in a forest in southern England without a head. We have no doubts that men can do that. And yet, when we start talking about men within Satanism who actually believe in evil and it's the right to express evil, we suddenly have a doubt.
Is this just an English disease, or should we be worried in Australia about activities such as this?
I think you must be worried in every country, including yours. And without a shadow of a doubt, you'll have groups in Australia who are doing similar things.